हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल टू सेशन 8 ऑफ कला से रूबरू, एन इनिशिएटिव टू सेलिब्रेट इंडियन क्राफ्टमैनशिप। सो डिजाइनिंग हैज सेवरल ऑफसेट्स टू इट। ईच पर्सन कार्व्स आउट देयर ओन नीश विद एन इमेंस क्रिएटिविटी। अमंग सच पीपल टुडे विद अस वी हैव तन्वी फ्रॉम हाउस ऑफ एकम। सो वेलकम तन्वी। स्टार्टिंग
हाय हाय सबने,
या
सॉरी सॉरी,
No, I was just saying I was welcoming you.
ओके,
Yeah,
या हाय, ग्रेट टू बी इन द कॉन्वर्सेशन। इट्स अ ग्रेट इनिशिएटिव।
thank you. So starting with our session, so tell us about your firm, the products and the services you offer.
श्योर। सो हाउस ऑफ एकम इज अ क्यूरेटेड ऑनलाइन मार्केट प्लेस ऑफ होम फर्निशिंग्स एंड होम डेकोर। वी सेल अ रेंज ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स रेंजिंग फ्रॉम क्विल्ट्स टू डॉहर्स, बेड शीट्स, कुशन कवर्स, वॉल आर्ट, बेसिकली एवरीथिंग दैट यू कैन इमेजिन अंडर द टैग ऑफ होम फर्निशिंग्स।
Okay.
एवरीथिंग इज हैंडमेड। वी
Wow.
सेल, या एवरीथिंग इज 100% हैंडमेड एंड 100% मेड इन इंडिया। So we do not source anything outside India, and everything is also directly sourced from the artisans in India. So yeah, we started around 3 years back now, and it's been a great ride.
Yeah, I can see like you guys have grown so much. And look at your page, there's so many things you offer. It's really exciting and colorful.
Thanks, thanks, thank you so much.
So in terms of education, what professionals, how did you take to the for the inception of this studio?
Okay, that's actually a very good question because I do not have any formal education in design or in textiles as such.
Okay.
Yeah, this was actually, I'm a maths graduate and a postgraduate.
Wow.
Yeah. So I have 3 years of work experience at a, I worked with an online company called FabFurnish.com.
Okay.
It was one of the biggest home furnishings company at that point of time. And that led to my journey actually in home textiles. My love for the products and my love for the flair of textiles grew from there. And luckily or unfortunately, you can say that company closed. And I thought I should start something of my own. And I was dabbling between two jobs in the beginning. And then finally, I thought that, you know, it's time to give my full attention to my own brand. And yeah, so no formal education as such, but definitely a lot of passion and a lot of work experience in the field. So
well, I'm really glad you did start your own firm. Okay, so in a world of industrial design and assembly lines, how did the decision of being a design maker come about?
So I'll be honest, you know, a lot of companies in India, you know, do not, especially in our field of home furnishings and home decor,
yeah,
do not have a very design oriented mind. You know, they'll do anything
right.
and everything from all over India without thinking that, you know, this pattern or particularly this color is the theme right now or this is what is trending. So abroad, you will see everything, you know, very systemized and in a very, how should I say, in a very trendy,
streamlined manner.
Yes, in a very streamlined manner. Yeah. So when we thought of starting our brand, you know, our main objective was to do multiple collections based on a certain theme and
yeah.
Definitely based on a certain colors and based on certain, for example, any particular pattern that we found from nature or our travels. So,
right.
Yeah, so we did not want to do a lot of, we were not a very abstract, you know, we don't do a lot of abstract. You'll see a lot of florals, you'll see a lot of prints.
Yeah.
In our products. So we try to encourage nature, encourage our travels in all our products.
Yeah, that's really great. And it feels really warm also to use fabric with hair, which is inspired by nature. It's really warm and welcoming. So when you say House of Acom, what was your ideology behind the brand name?
Oh, behind the brand name, actually, we took a long time to finally get to the brand name. So Acom is a word in Sanskrit.
Yeah.
Which means to unite.
Right,
so,
right.
So what we wanted our products to do was to unite your home. So our ideology was that with every product of our company, it will sort of bring together your house. So that's why the new House of Acom.
Oh, that's really nice. Okay, so but every artist has a story of how they fell in love with your stuff. What is yours, and how did the exploring of fabric upholstery begin?
I fell in love with the craft of block printing when I started this company, actually. So before that also, in the market, everyone was doing a lot of no one was doing a lot of block printing, and even if they were doing block prints, they were all aided by machine. So I fell in love with the nature of handmade block printing. So once, I think I remember on a trip to Jaipur, I think once I saw something which was getting block printed. I think it was a quilt. And there it was. I was like, you know, this has to be translated to different mediums. And I remember, I think I stayed on for 2-3 days, mentioned it to my husband. And we were like, you know, this has to come to mainstream as much as we can. So we just decided, I think,
block printing, I mean, especially the field of Rajasthan, you know, people do those block printing is really exciting and very interesting. Carrying on, what style do you categorize your designs under?
It's very tough to categorize, actually, but I'll say definitely feminine, definitely colorful, and definitely floral. Yeah, I think if you could call to go with something, something colorful, feminine, floral, that go to.
And so, what is the process of your products from inception to idea to the finished product? How is the process?
So, as I said, all our prints are inspired by nature or by our travels, or it can be anything that we saw, even by, you know, we were just traveling to a grocery store and we saw something beautiful on the way. So, it's literally that. We, we can take a picture of that, or we have some photographs of it already. Then we try to have that thing on paper. Then we hand it over to our artisans in Jaipur, who then create a block out of it. And then that block is obviously then we decide the colors associated with everything. The Pantones, and then then everything is printed. So we try to do like the same block we try to use in maybe 2-3 product categories. Maybe we'll do the same in a curtain or a quilt or a bed sheet. So, it's pretty much from nature to pen to the computer and then to my artisan.
Nice. That's really nice. So, where do you source all your materials from?
It's a mix. As you said, mainly our printing is done in Jaipur.
Okay.
But we source a variety of stuff. From Odisha, like our wall baskets are from Odisha, our planters are from Panipat, our cushions are from Assam. So, all over India. Yeah.
So, have you tied up with any of these local artisans all over the country, as you mentioned?
Yeah. So, yes, we do have a certain group of artisans which only work for us. Across different areas in India. So definitely they exclusively make products for us.
So you don't like, do you get them to your workshop and then like how, or do they stay in their place of
No, it's in their
origin
own
and
workshop. No, it's in their own workshop, but that workshop only
okay.
produces our products. So yeah.
Oh, okay. That's really nice. Yeah, I mean, keeping them in their local environment and producing
Yeah.
their types of design in their setup is that's really nice. So you have explored a great deal of functions for cotton bags and baskets. So what changes have you done in to the product to suit the purpose? Like you have for, say, for papers, you have some for plants. So how do you change the product to suit its function?
So, when we started Jute Planters, we started it obviously because the trend of indoor plants.
Yeah.
We also obviously wanted to give the customer the how should I say the way the method on how they can store their indoor plants. So from jute to cotton was very I'll say it was very practical for the what we did was a very practical way because what we noticed was that with jute you can't wash jute. So with cotton you can completely wash it, you can even put it in the washing machine. So again,
Right.
cotton is more easy handling, cotton has more brighter colors. So it's sort of evolved on its own because we also heard a lot of people saying that, you know, it gets a bit dirty, it gets tough to clean. So
Yeah.
yeah, it was pretty much based on feedback of our customers. And yeah, pretty much that, I guess, yeah.
Okay, so do you have any kind of special treatment done for, say, the planters, since like I mean, the water retention and basically for the water aspect?
Yeah, so everything that is so the jute and cotton both, when it's braided in ropes,
Yeah.
they're first completely dried and a special
Yeah.
treatment is done. But to be honest, it will not completely hold. I mean, it can't hold water. I mean,
Yeah.
the nature of the material is such,
Right.
but definitely absorbs a bit. So, for example, even if you overwater your plants a bit and the water seeps in, it's not going to get spoiled. So, you'll say like
Oh.
half a glass or one glass of water, it can easily absorb. But if you flood it, then obviously it won't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what kind of balance do you strike between prototyping and digital design?
So, as I said, we do not have anything. We have everything handmade, right?
Yeah.
So yeah. So you mean to say prototyping between the design and
Even in terms of block printing, the same thing can be done in digital designing as well.
right.
So that is where, like, I think in, on your hand, because everything is done handmade, that is where the X factor comes into your products.
Yeah.
That's great. So now you have a really a huge variety of products. What materials in terms of fabrics have you explored?
So we do a lot of cotton. I mean, mainly it's cotton
Yeah.
in furnishing, you'll say. In cotton, there are multiple varieties. I mean, you know, it's cambric, it's mull, it's a lot of varieties. I mean, it's unlimited in cotton. Similarly, with towels, we do a lot of waffle. We do a lot of TNT also.
Okay.
Yeah, and in planters, you've seen we do a lot of jute and cotton again. And
Right.
in grass baskets, we do a naturally grown grass, which is grown in the state of Odisha only. So yeah, that's in yeah. So grass, cotton. Cotton and silk also. Yes, silk also we do.
Oh,
Silk is,
wow.
yeah, so we do silk, which is mainly made in Gujarat itself, in Patan.
Okay.
So that's one thing, yeah. So mushroom silk and cotton and yeah, grass.
Oh, nice. So it's a lot of cotton and associated materials. So describe a personal favorite creation of yours and how you went about creating it. What was the process?
I think my personal favorite will be the tie-dye quilt, which we
you,
have.
Is it possible for us to show any of your products while you talk about it?
Oh, actually, my son is outside, and if I go outside, he's
oh
podcast.
No, let's
discussion wouldn't be possible then. Okay. As I dogged myself in the room. So yeah, so it's a blue shibori quilt that we
okay.
That was one of our first designs actually. We did, which I think definitely my favorite. It's hand tie dyed and it's beautiful. So yeah.
So how did you how did you come about the idea for it?
I remember seeing something tie-dyed. I think it was a dupatta that I saw at the workshop. And I remember mentioning it to my karigar that, you know, why don't we turn this dupatta into a quilt? So
yeah.
It was not the same print. It was something in pink, I think. So I said that, you know, indigo is something that is my favorite color. So I said indigo is, again, it's natural. It's very in. So
yeah.
He created that indigo indigo print, and he converted it into a quilt for me. And yeah, I think it was the site first. I looked at it, and then it was the idea of turning something else into the quilt. So yeah,
that's nice. So all these products you curate, where do you display and eventually sell your designs? Of course, I know you have a Instagram profile, but have you been a part of exhibitions or do you have a store in back home?
No. So we sell everything online. We have participated in exhibitions, but our main source to retail is online. So you see, it's on our website basically. I mean, Instagram and website. We sell mainly on our website and also on Etsy for all international orders.
Okay.
Yeah.
So have you had any local exhibition held?
Long time back. I mean, we've had exhibitions in Ahmedabad where we stay right now, in New Delhi also, but long time back now.
What threat does your business face from mass-produced designs? Do you see your designs as a mass-produced version of themselves?
I'm sorry, I didn't get the first part.
I'm saying, like, what threat do you face, or what threat does your business face from mass-produced designs?
Threat, I mean, obviously, the same design can be produced in bulk. Obviously, I mean, people are doing it all over, and then obviously the beauty of the product goes less.
Right.
That is definitely there. The threat is mainly when people copy. So, you know, internet is full of people who will just copy your prototype or your booty or print, anything. I mean, they'll even copy small stuff that they see on internet.
Yeah.
And they'll even copy the picture. So the same picture you will see on some other profile. And they will tell others that they can bulk produce it in 100 quantities or 200. So the act of plagiarism is, I think, a big threat to us. And it happens. It happens a lot, actually. But since we're selling online, we really can't do much. And copywriting really doesn't help a printed product. So, I mean, that threat will always be there, I guess.
I guess the beauty and originality of your product just helps itself to stand out. I mean, digital printed and hand printed is, like, there is no comparison between the two of them.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you can see it. I mean, you know, you can just see it with your eye.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
For all the future artists out there, how do you set the price of your product.
Oh, that's interesting. Price is it's a very tricky subject, you know. A lot of artists I've seen, a lot of brands sells price their products very low. Some will price their products very high. I mean, it should be a balance. You know, you ultimately want to sell it. You want to sell them ultimately. You do not want to keep them at home. So it should be a sweet point between a lot of market research, number one. Number two, something that your costing allows you to. And number three, there should be sufficient margin for you to market your product, and also
Of course.
sufficient margin for you to have something when you sell it.
Yeah.
So it's a mix of a lot of factors, but definitely, I mean, you should not price your product just because an X brand is retailing the same product or something similar at a lower price. You
Yeah.
know your product's worth, you know your product's value better than anyone
Right.
else. So even the market research, yes, it's important, but you should not be governed by it.
Right. Yeah, I think you set the benchmark for your own products with the value you add to it.
Completely.
Okay, so have you tied up with any upholstery stores or and how did you come up with, if yes, how did you come up with it?
So we do, as I said, we do not sell offline a lot. We were selling at a few stores in Ahmedabad, but not very recently, because you know
Okay.
with our nature of the fabric, and especially now in COVID, it's almost impossible to, you know, we do not have, we don't want to risk any of our products being touched by multiple people, because you know we have a
Right.
small team.
Right.
It's just me and my husband. We take care of everything, and that's how we guarantee that it's hygienic and it's safe.
Yeah.
So yeah, so
Right.
I don't think, we do not see ourselves especially in COVID, tying up with anything which is physical right now. Definitely online, yes.
But apart from like the COVID situation, have you considered tying up with any stores to expand your business?
As I said, online, yes, definitely. With offline stores, as I said, it's tricky right now, but yes, we have considered, I
Yeah.
mean, a variety of stores. Mainly international, you know, in India not much, but yeah, international we have got a lot of queries also, and we have considered quite a few stores.
Oh, that's I'd love to see your products going across the seas and finding in multiple places. So, do you believe in collaboration and customization according to a client's demand, or do you strictly sell as per your catalog?
No, we are open to customizations, definitely. Customization of a print is very tough, because when
Yeah.
we get it printed, we get it printed in small quantities, and we cannot get it printed again, you know, just to basically suit the customer in terms of the print, in terms of length, in terms of something he wants to get his initials embroidered, or if he wants a certain mix and match of something, you know, that we're definitely open to, and we do it also quite often.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people like their products to be customized and more personal to them. So,
Yeah,
yeah.
definitely. That's the personalization we do, yeah.
There is always a period of struggle to reach a milestone in life. What was yours?
So struggle is always, I mean, I think it's still there.
Yeah.
We're not a good earth, or you know, we're not a very established brand. So to get to that level, obviously, there is a certain amount of struggle. I think the main struggle is obviously getting the people to know your brand,
Right.
and and number two is making people understand that why this product, or why our product is better than something that you will buy at a home center, or you know, at
Right.
Home Town. So why is it
Yeah.
better and why you should buy us is very it's always been a struggle, and I think it will always be, because
No, yeah, that's true.
Indian mindset still believes that, you know, what you're getting there, what or you or earlier what you were getting from China, you know, the cheaper quality stuff is something that they generally get holds on to because it's the Indian mindset. So yeah,
Right.
getting people to know that handmade is the way forward, and definitely one should buy local. Is
Definitely.
something it takes time, but and support small brands. Definitely, I mean, do not.
Yeah.
I would personally not want. I would personally like to educate people and tell them that, you know, support a small artisanal brand rather than supporting a Myntra or a Flipkart or an Amazon, right?
Yeah.
You also have thousands of people supporting them. So, you know, who will
Yeah,
support
small
us?
brands and also local artisans. I mean, since at
Yeah.
the given day, they're dying out. So
Yeah,
it
yeah.
is the need of the hour to support their work.
Definitely, definitely. Every day, yeah. One must.
What was your biggest challenge till date, or like as you just described, it's a thing which goes on.
Yeah, the same. I mean,
Yeah.
this challenge, I think, is the one that we face every day.
Right.
Yeah, I think it's the same. I'll have the same answer to this. Yeah.
So what are you currently working on?
Currently, we are working on a new collection of wedding.
Okay.
We'll see a lot of new quilts, a lot of new dohers, bed sheets. We're also doing a new collection of wall art,
Oh,
which
wow.
one will be very soon. And what else? Yeah, I think these two are our main collections right now, which will be out very soon.
Yeah, that's really, I'm waiting to have a look at it, definitely. What would you like to say to the future designers out there?
See, I'll be honest, I'm not a qualified designer as such. I can only give
I believe
advice.
anyone who creates something of their own is a designer. You don't need to have a qualification for it.
Yeah, thank you so much. So, yeah, I think to artists or to entrepreneurs, you know, that's what I can say is that, you know,
Yeah.
definitely follow your heart and do not give up, because it's a long ride and it's a very it's a hard ride. It takes time, but when you come to that stage where you can finally, you know, self-sustain yourself and finally you can be proud of what you've created, it's all worth it. So hang in there. It takes time, but yeah, it's worth it.
Definitely. Thank you for your insight. We'll be concluding our session now. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us.
Thank you so much, Savni. It was great talking to you.
Same here.
Thank you.
Bye. Looking forward to your upcoming collection, and let's keep in touch.
Definitely, definitely.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.